Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is John Shaner. I'm the band director at Shenandoah Valley High School. I'd like to welcome you to our concert this afternoon for Music in Our Schools Month. We would like to, first of all, thank you all for coming, and second of all, please rise if you're able as we perform our national anthem. The next tune that we like to play is from the Russian Orthodox Choral Library. This is Salvation is Created. It's a Russian Orthodox style choral anthem composed in 1912 by Pavel Chesnikov. It is one of the very last sacred works he composed before he was forced to turn to the secular arts by the oppressive Soviet Union. Although he never heard his own composition performed, his children had the opportunity years following his death. We hope you enjoy Salvation is Created. Thank you. The next piece we like to perform is called The Great Locomotive Chase, and this one is kind of like a train simulator. If you ever were familiar with that game that was out a few years ago, it's about My score's all ripped. In the early years of the Civil War, Georgia was largely protected from military hostilities, leaving it free to ship arms, ammunitions, food, and supplies to Confederate troops on the battlefield to the northeast. It was the importance of the extensive rail system to the Confederates that prompted James Andrews, a Union spy from Kentucky, to attempt a daring effort to disrupt the 138-mile rail line conducting Atlanta and Chattanooga. Along with 19 Union soldiers dressed as civilians, Andrews arrived in Marietta on April 12, 1862. Here they boarded a train called the General, a wood-burning locomotive. At Big Shanty, the train stopped so passengers and crew could eat breakfast, and then what happened was the gentleman stole the train and derailed it. So this is kind of that simulation of a train derailment.
Thank you.
Thank you. This next piece that we like to perform is called Arabian Dances. And the program says, after a long day's journey, the nomads set up camp for the evening. As the sun casts its final searing rays on the desert landscape, a campfire roars to life and the celebration begins. As the sky darkens, the festivities grow wilder and wilder until eventually three groups of revelers take turns dancing at the edge of the fire, each trying to outdo the other. Finally, the entire tribe joins, dancing wildly for hours. We hope you enjoy Arabian Dances. Thank you. Next, we'd like to do a traditional song, The Water is Wide. Thank you. Next, we'd like to do a classic from Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. This is Pure Imagination, and it was written in 1971 by Leslie Bracusi and Anthony Newley. With its message of endless possibilities and dreams fulfilled, it has remained popular in the 70s as it is today, as said by the 5.5 million views on YouTube. So we hope you enjoy Pure Imagination. Before we do our final selection today, I would like to thank a few people. First of all, the Shenandoah Valley School District Board of Education, along with our superintendent, Mr. Brian Waite, who is here today. Thank you for your support. Mr. John Brennan, our high school principal. Mr. Chris Conroy, our assistant principal. Our Bob Udinski, who does SV Public Relations. Our band boosters, our private music teachers, the community, our alumni band members. I'd also like to thank the Shenandoah Sentinel for coming down today to help cover the event. I'd also like to thank Chuck Neidhart and PMEA for putting on this concert series every year, as well as Representatives Watro and Torzik and Senator Argel for all your work today in talking with the students and answering questions. It was a very informative session we had this morning. And last but not least, I would like to thank the students behind me who have worked so hard. We have a concert here today, then we're playing two tomorrow morning for our elementary students for Music in Our Schools Month, so they're going to be a little tired by the end of the week. So how about one more hand for our students here? Everybody stand up. All right. And the last piece needs no introduction, but I'm going to give it one anyways. This is America the Beautiful.